Roger Berghoff has always been drawn by the sea, so he often takes pen in hand to return the favor.
I often will choose the boat scenes because they offer me or afford me the possibility of working with something rather traditional in subject matter. I was raised in eastern Washington, so I wasn't really raised on the coast, although it seemed like it was always a real highlight to our year to spend time going to the coast.
Going to the coast is a lot easier these days. For one, Roger now lives just minutes from settings like this in Port Orchard, Washington. What's more, he no longer has to ride here in his dad's Ford coupe.
My brother and I were quite small at the time. We frequently would come across the mountain in the trunk because it was the only place that we could fit. So in order for us to get over here, we often had the fumes of the... They have to stop every few minutes to make sure we weren't getting too many fumes. But we would arrive in Seattle, and it was always a... Or on the coast, and it was always a new awakening. And it was an excitement because of the... having the problems of getting there were always rather disastrous.
Roger is in the driver's seat now when he travels to scenery like this, and there are many who feel he's also in the driver's seat as today's finest Northwest silkscreen artist. While silkscreen art dates back nearly 1,000 years, the photo finishing process, which Roger uses, is only 25 years old. It starts where many artists stop, with a finished sketch.
Generally, it of course, is a matter of starting with an original drawing and getting your ideas and putting them into drawing form. From that, I usually make separations, figuring out how I would like the color to be interplayed with the various elements or the drawing form, and then going from there.
From there, Roger's original sketch is separated and retraced onto as many as 6 transparencies. Then the transparencies are either hand-cut or light-exposed onto a gelatin-type material. Once this gelatin is transferred to the silk boards, the silk screening process can begin.
So many of the medias are rather restrictive in what they actually will allow you to do. And here I think you can combine not only the transparency of watercolor and this concept, but you can also get very opaque and very solid in color, and everything in between. So it does allow some additional advantages, I think, media-wise, that you just don't get from other particular materials that you can work with.
Those advantages, though, are time-consuming. The process we've shown you in a matter of minutes may take Roger up to 300 hours to complete. But once he does, Roger can make hundreds of original graphics from the same screen, each one showing its colors just a little differently than the next.
My whole intent originally was that I would do something that the average person could enjoy and have a piece of artwork and have something that is an original piece.
When someone looks at your work, what do you hope they get out of it?
A little nostalgia of the Northwest and appreciation. I think we can share that. That's, but not just for the Northwest, but for other people as well.
And once that scene from Charleston, Oregon, or Puget Sound has been declared shipshape, Roger signs and ships them off to galleries as remote as South Africa. It's at this point that he's once again ready to draw what he's drawn to, a continuing process that for Roger seems as smooth as silk.